Hey guys, and welcome back to another video. So today I'm going to be making some milanesas, and I'm going to be making them in the large BlackLock series. So these skillets are somewhat more expensive than the standard stuff that Lodge produces. Reason being is that they're casted thinner, so they're lighter weight, they're triple seasoned, and the other thing would be that they are, you know, stamped or casted with the BlackLock name. And if you guys don't know who or what BlackLock was, it was actually the original name of their foundry before it burned down in 1910. So there's a little bit of history, nostalgia, prestige, you know, behind the name, and I like it a lot. And I think they did the name justice. You know, they did a great job with all the way they did it. You know, the sloped sides. It's almost like a chef skillet. The lightweight and the triple seasoning. The seasoning isn't the best, but the color of it is almost a jet black. They're, you know, super glossy, and they are super dark compared to their standard stuff. Now, I hear a lot of people complain about Lodge's seasoning. I think Lodge has great seasoning compared to many other cast iron manufacturers. So I want to say that I am a big supporter, and I love the Lodge seasoning. So to me, there's no reason for you to strip down these skillets. There's no reason for you to strip down the original Lodge skillets, but to each their own, you know. And if you want to strip them down, great. There is a lot of people that like to start fresh, and I feel like, you know, Finex, Smithy, Butterpat, Stargazer, all these other companies, they have great products. Great, you know, they mill them down, they sand them down, they do investment castings, they do hand pours, and they're great. The only thing is that their seasoning is always, you have to build it yourself. And if you're new to cast iron, that's gonna be a pain. That's gonna be hard, especially if you don't know how to season properly. You're gonna give up and you're gonna say, well, why was it that I paid $250 for a 10-inch skillet that cooks horribly, you know? And that's the issue with high-priced cast iron, is that sometimes people aren't going to appreciate, you know, the amount of work you put into it, you know, the amount of hours that you put into a skillet, whether you're milling it by hand or sanding it by hand or seasoning it by hand. So I feel like Lodge is a great option for those that don't want to spend such a premium price and still get high quality cast iron, because the BlackLock series, like I mentioned, is lighter weight. It's actually smoother than their standard stuff. And, you know, the design and the quality of it is actually very great. So there's no issues for me on the BlackLock series. So I think it's a very underrated series that Lodge offers. Now, I do hope that, Lodge continues to make more BlackLock products, or maybe do some small updates on the, like, let's just say the handle. The handle design is not my favorite. It's a little sharp on the edges, and, I feel like they could do something different. But other than that, you know, the helper handle, I say probably one of the best ones. I like them a lot. The handles on the, like on the brazier, great size. Same thing with the Dutch oven, great size. So no issues there. The lids also great, but like I said, a very underrated, and I feel like they're a great piece of cast iron that you can pick up. Anyway, guys, that was it. I hope you guys enjoyed this quick video. And as always, I appreciate your time. Thank you guys for watching.